Hey Cafe Crew, it's Colin Smith here, and today I'm going to show you how to change hair color. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily change the color of hair. We're going to go over everything from blonde to black and some kind of fun colors as well. I grabbed this image from Adobe stock. Don't forget to check it out. In fact, you can get 10 free images. The links are underneath. So why don't we get started? The very first thing we need to do is to select the hair. So we're going to grab our quick select tool. And then just go around the hair. Now don't worry if you go over the edge, we can easily fix that by hitting the Alt key on Windows, that'd be Option on Mac, and just going back in here. All right, that's not bad. We've got a pretty rough selection. Now what we want to do is refine that by going up to the Select and Mask. Now when we're under Select and Mask, see this tool here, the second one, that's the one we want to use. And that's our refine edge. So we're going to take this just around here, around the hairline right there. And let that just kind of refine around the face. We're also going to take it down here. Just where there's going to be some flyaway hair, as we want to just try and select those a little bit better. All right, and let's play around with our radius a little bit on our edges. Could turn on our smart radius if we wanted. Sometimes that helps. And then we want to turn on decontaminate colors. And then we're going to go to a new layer with a layer mask and click OK. All right, we've sort of cut out the hair. We might have to refine that a little bit as we go. But let's turn on the background now. So I'm going to show you several different things. We're going to start with some extremes. Let's do black and blonde, and then we'll move on to some kind of fun colors. So why don't we start here by adding a hue saturation adjustment layer. Now the next layer I'm going to add is I'm going to add a curves adjustment layer. And between these two, I'm going to get most of what we need. Now, I want to make sure they're affecting just this layer here with the hair cut out. And the way to do that is just to select each one. And see that little icon? You can click on there and it'll put the little arrow. Or the other thing we can do is hold down the Alt key on Windows, Option on Mac, go between the two layers and click. And that will also do the same thing. So what it's doing is it's constraining those adjustments just to the layer with the hair on it. So why don't we start with black? So we're going to take the hue saturation and we're going to pull the saturation all the way down. All right, so now we've got gray. If you're wondering how to get gray hair, it's right there. Now I'm just noticing there's a couple of little spots here that are not exactly perfect. And I'm not going to waste time doing that. You could just grab a small brush and just kind of paint those areas on that mask to get it perfect. But the focus of this tutorial, of course, is on changing hair color. So now we're going to grab curves. Now we're going to go from gray to black, go to about the 1/4 area there, and then we're just going to click and drag this down. And there we go. We can go into the blacks there. Now, don't go too far. I mean, you could go all the way down here, but I feel like for the toning of the picture, it's a little unnatural. So maybe take it to about there. And then we can also drop it down there a little bit if you want to reduce those highlights. Or, of course, you know, you could increase those highlights if you wanted to make it look more shiny. One of the other things we could do too is if we go down there under the saturation, we could give it just a little bit there. So we could make it kind of like a dark brown. There we go. And that's another option. All right, so why don't we go back here? I'm just going to reset the color here just by clicking on that little curvy arrow thing, and that will reset it. So we're resetting our hue saturation. Let's go down to our curves, and we're going to also reset that. Great. Let's go for blonde. So we're going to go up here and then we're going to push up the highlights. And let's just play around a little bit there. Okay, one of the things we want to do now is go back to the saturation, because one of the mistakes people do is they do too much saturation. Pull that back a little bit. And there we go. Now it's going to start to look more natural, like blonde. We got like a kind of Khaleesi thing going on here now. All right, so why don't we just go back to our curves again? And we're just going to reset our curves, go back to our hue saturation, and reset that. Now, if we move this around, you'll see that we can get some real kind of cool, fun effects here. You know, we can go into this kind of very kind of a copper effect there. Play around with the saturation too. And of course, we could drop that down a little bit, make it look a little bit more natural. And then we can go into these kind of purples and pinks, blues that we've all seen and love. There we go. There's into the blues. And of course, you could go for Halloween here, which is a little much, but let's drop it down just a little bit and give it a little less saturation. And I think it starts to look more realistic. And then we can see there just by moving that, now we can go into some of the kind of greens, make it a little more saturated or less saturated. You know, more saturated might be when she just dyed it, and then, you know, it, once it wears in, being washed a couple of times, it's going to go into that. So you can see there's a lot of different things. Okay, let's just do one more thing. I'm going to reset this, and then what we're going to do here is I'm going to take the curve, I'm going to take the hue saturation, and let's go in and we're going to colorize it a really interesting color. So let's go into something like this, the blue. And now I'm going to choose the mask and I'm going to hit Control I for inverse. Now I'm going to hit here, Control J. We're going to copy it again, clip it. And of course, what we want to do is hit the Shift and click on there just so we can see what's going on here. And let's try a different color. Let's go into kind of like that color. Maybe drop the saturation down a tad. Excellent. And let's hit Control J. Let's make another copy. And let's try a different color. There we go. That's kind of fun. Now we're just going to hit the Shift and click there to turn those masks off. So what we could do now is if we wanted to get kind of crazy, we could grab a brush and then we could actually do colored streaks in here. So let me drop the opacity down to about 50 by tapping the 5, and then let's make the brush a little bit bigger. And then you could kind of just kind of paint those in if you wanted to just create colored streaks. Okay, to make that brush bigger. And now I'm just kind of blending those together a little bit. And now it's starting to look a little bit more realistic. Now I'm using pressure sensitivity on here to kind of blend these in. Because at first it was looking a little unnatural, wasn't it? So now we're starting to get a little bit more realistic. All right, there we go. Now she's ready to go to Burning Man. So all right, there's some different things that you can do with hair color. By the way, I grabbed this image from Adobe stock. Don't forget to check it out. In fact, you can get 10 free images. And also, why don't you contribute your own photos to Adobe stock and make a little bit of extra money? The links are underneath. So anyway, that's this week's tutorial. If you want more tutorials like this, hit the subscribe button and you won't miss out on the new tutorials. If you like this, smash that like button into dust, add a comment, let's get a discussion going, and until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.